course, the media, the intellectual property law, is actually really very important. And also, I think that those two terms are so familiar to the public, especially when it comes to business nowadays. I mean, business is not going to fall for you, right?
Right. If you come to the problem, then you might have an issue that you can help you with.
So, if you look at the most common questions that you get, I think that people are familiar with it, you know,
sure, we get a lot of questions around content and its usage. Can I use this clip? Can I use this photo? Can I use this video? Can I use this chart? Well, you are in business and might be no, but also might be yes. Is it in the public domain? Is it fair use? Mm-hmm. Do you have a clear change title? Did you find this on Google Docs? I can save it. You know, this is going to be done in the sophistication of the client and the team. But a lot of questions around copyright and what is okay as far as using and reusing content. We also get a lot of questions about protecting brands. Is a hashtag protectable? Can we trademark a hashtag? Can we trademark any slogan? What about this logo? We also assist with new marketing efforts. How do we just quickly state a contact rule that's compliant with our social media platforms in different states and federal offices? How do we make sure that we are disclosing connections with people who write about our product or service on Instagram? Do they have to disclose that we gave them credentials for a year or something? How do we do that? And then, of course, we have all the regular questions on starting a new business, and the contract, what's with the contract? And on the other hand, I think my partner, how do I get out of this? I want to see the picture because of that. That's how it covers it. And then, we also have a big definition mark up with the surrounding statements made about people and businesses.
That definition, because I think that's an important thing to use for the first time to talk to somebody.
That's right. So, I mean, the most devastating thing that can take place online is if there's a concerted attack against your business by a rogue employee or and half the time you can't do much because we have this thing called the First Amendment and clients and employees are entitled to their opinions for that view. But if those opinions are false statements that are made maliciously, especially or just made purposefully to impact negatively, then those are excellent. So we do a lot of conversations around should you follow a lawsuit around this? Should you pursue this legally? Should you pursue this in a PR fashion? Right? Content to mitigate the
best stuff that can take it away. When people, what should this mean?
Really important. There's a 1 year statute of limitations. So you can't kind of see something that's false and then sit on it and then decide in year two or three you're sick of putting it when you Google your name or your business. You really have to act relatively quickly in order to attempt to address the statement. If you want to
see
that person.
Yes, yeah, you can. Or talk to them if you put the filter. If you want to see that person, you can ask yourself, how much I have to do with the first limitations when it comes to that. When you see this piece of mind, right? So sometimes you just kind of want to break it
down. Also, not someone you've extended the post. The perception that I found out on Friday, so I didn't hear from Friday. It's actually from when it was posted. So it's on you to be vigilant, and yes, your statute of limitations runs as soon as the statement was published, not from when you discovered it. online at staplelaw.com. We're also on all the various social media platforms with the handle at staplelaw. Revenge for women, such that all the topics that are relevant to my